Croeso, and welcome back to my channel. Today is St. David's Day, the patron saint of Wales. Even though he might not be as widely known as the Irish St. Patrick, he's just as important. So let's take a closer look at this special day. First of all, what is St. David's Day? Well, it's definitely one of the most important days of the year in Wales. If you happen to be in Wales on the 1st of March, chances are you look around and see green leeks and yellow daffodils, the national emblems, everywhere. And of course, the Idrar y Goch, the Welsh flag. Usually, you would find a variety of parades and concerts to honour St. David, but also to honour everything Welsh, including the Eisteddfodau, the music, culture and Welsh language festivals. And of course, on this special day, you'll hear the Welsh national anthem, sung with even more pride than usual. In short, the St. David's Day is one big celebration of everything Welsh throughout the nation. So, you could well say that St. David's Day is the Welsh equivalent to the Irish St. Patrick's and the Scottish St. Andrew's Day. But there's one big difference. While St. Patrick's Day and St. Andrew's Day are public holidays in the respective countries, St. David's Day is actually not. Not that there wasn't a discussion, or that the Welsh people wouldn't want to make it a public holiday for the nation, but despite all efforts so far, their request was denied by the British government. But back to the man who gave this special day its name, St. David, or in Welsh, Dewi Sant. If you are not Welsh, I suppose your knowledge of this special saint may be limited to his name and his association with Wales. Well, mine certainly was, before I started to dig a bit. So here are the most important facts. David was a Welsh preacher, monk, and even the Archbishop of Wales. He was born in the late 5th or early 6th century, somewhere in the southwest of Wales, near the place we now know as City of St. David. By the way, that makes him the only one of the four patron saints of Great Britain and Ireland that was born in the land he's patron saint of. During his lifetime, he founded a lot of Catholic churches and communities, and legend has it that he also founded the well-known Abbey of Glastonbury. But no saint story is complete without a few miracles. Rumor has it that he was able to restore sight to a blind man, his own teacher to be precise. And when he was preaching, according to legend on the day he became archbishop, and the crowd that had gathered around him had a hard time understanding him, he is said to have raised the earth beneath him to form a small hill so that everyone would be able to hear what he had to say. David's faith was so strong that he even went on a journey to Jerusalem to find spiritual enlightenment. And when he returned, he carried a stone with him. A stone that can still be found on an altar in St. David's Cathedral. The cathedral that does not just bear his name, but according to legend, is also erected on the very place of the monastery David lived in. His life came to an end on the 1st of March 589. According to some sources, he might even have been older than 100 years at that time. His last words? Be joyful, keep the faith, and do the little things that you have heard and seen me do. The phrase Gwenerhi pedi, better man bithet, do the small things in life, or smile at the small things in life, is still a well-known phrase in Wales. For all he had done during his lifetime, Pope Calixtus canonized him in the 12th century, making him the patron saint of Wales, and in a way, starting the tradition of the St. David's Day. And even today, you can feel and even see his influence, for his name can be found everywhere. So, what are special traditions on St. David's Day? And what's the deal with leeks and the daffodils? Well, daffodils are simply a common sight during the time St. David's Day is held, and is used as a symbol for Wales only since the early 20th century. And what about the leeks? Well, Saint David was not just known as a vegetarian. He was also known, or at least rumored, to have a special diet, consisting of only water and, yeah, leeks. So this could be one explanation for why the leek has become a national symbol of Wales. Another explanation, though, could lie in another legend. A legend in which the saint had told Welsh soldiers to wear leeks on their helmets when going into battle. Well, this was to better distinguish between one another and the enemies, who actually wore similar-looking armor. And according to that legend, this was a crucial factor in winning the battle against the Saxons. But maybe it doesn't have anything to do with the saint, but goes back way further, to the days of the Celtic druids. They were said to have used leeks for protection and to heal minor diseases. But the leek seems to have been misunderstood, and so in the end, the daffodil also earned its place as a national symbol. So, if you decide to celebrate St. David's Day, leeks and daffodils sure make beautiful and meaningful decorations. Even though today St. David's Day is more a celebration of everything Welsh, it's definitely also a religious holiday. So if you feel like exploring the religious side of the holiday, it's never wrong to go to the town where St. David was born. Like mentioned before, today that place is located in the southwest of Wales, in Pembrokeshire, and it's also called St. David's. It's the religious center of Wales, and definitely worth to be visited, even if it's just to feel closer to the saint himself. By the way, it's said that two pilgrimages to St. David's is worth the same as one to Rome. If that's true, can only be judged by those who try. If you are not the religious type, but want to celebrate the day as a celebration of everything Welsh, how about joining one of the numerous parades? Or visit sites like castles or museums, or visit a concert, enjoy traditional Welsh songs. Or how about joining a bigger event, like the Croeso, a two-day event in Swansea, with Welsh music, cookery demonstrations, food stalls, and even a sub-event called Daffodil Dash. Or maybe the Asdaffodi, a festival for and with school children, including traditional Welsh folk songs, poems, literature readings, and so much more. Honestly, there are events everywhere in Wales, and especially in its capital, Cardiff. So if you have the chance, join the festivities and just enjoy the rich Welsh culture. But if you can't attend the festivals in Wales, how about just putting on some traditional Welsh music? Use some leeks and daffodils as decorations and make some traditional or at least typical dishes for St. David's Day. Need any suggestions? How about a nice leek soup? Or caul, a classic stew? Or why not bake your own butter bread, speckled bread, a fruit loaf that is actually prepared with tea? Some recipes for those dishes are probably handed down over generations, but you should be easily able to find fitting recipes on the internet. So try something new, and try those traditional dishes. So now you should have an impression what St. David's Day is, how it's celebrated, and who he was in the first place. So time to get onto it. Time to celebrate everything Welsh. Dith Gwyl Davy Happys. Happy St. David's Day. Thank you for listening. Have you ever been to a St. David's Day parade? Or do you happen to be Welsh and know of any traditions I failed to mention? Let me know in the comments down below. See you next time. Bye!